Hello everyone, welcome back to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. Today, it is not me doing the video, I am passing over to my good friend Scott Friesen, who is over at the channel Simpletivity. He's going to be diving into AmpleNote today. I'm actually going to be jumping on his channel to dive into AmpleNote and my thoughts as well. We're doing a bit of like a channel swap for today. So this video is going to be about AmpleNote, which is a note-taking application that has some really cool features in terms of like task score, has a really lightweight frame, and we're going to be going through it in a lot of detail. Scott's video here today is going to explore it. You can check out my opinions of it over on his channel, Simpletivity, which will be below. So I hope you enjoy today's video. A huge thanks to Scott for coming on, and I look forward to some of your thoughts and opinions on AmpleNote in the comments below. Anyway, guys, I'll talk to you very, very soon. Cheerio, and here's Scott.
Hello everyone, Scott Friesen here from Simpletivity, helping you to get more done and enjoy less stress. And I'm so excited to be back here on the Keep Productive channel, giving you my review of AmpleNote. Now, just before we dive in, if you want to see Francesco's take on AmpleNote, be sure to visit the Simpletivity channel for his review. So let's dive in. AmpleNote is a relatively newcomer to the note-taking app space, but I really like what they are doing, because the way that they are bringing notes, ideas, and tasks together, I think is really unique and is also really special. So let me give you a quick overview over here on the left-hand side of our screen. We start with something called Jots. We next have notes and then finally tasks. And really the idea here within AmpleNote is to take something from a quick idea or maybe a brainstorming session or just something that's popped up in your head and take it through that process of maybe fleshing it out as a note and then finally managing that task. Now, Jots is really a place for you to grab those really super quick ideas. We're not talking about meeting notes. We're talking about those things that maybe are distracting you from the task that you're working on at hand. The way that it works is that everything is listed by date. So, because today is February 1st, here I have my February 1st daily Jots. And you can see some of the previous ones as well. I can always go back to previous days. But the idea here is to grab those very quick, simple notes. How often have you been using a note-taking app and it is such a struggle or such an inconvenience for you to start an entirely new note and give it a title and a name or a date, and you don't even need that much, right? You just want to quickly get in and out of your note-taking app. So that's the great thing here with Jots, is just to quickly get that information down so you can get back to what you're working on. Now, if we come over to notes, you'll actually notice that those Jots do exist here, which is an important thing because now we can take them and transform them into maybe more fully fleshed ideas, right? We can link to web pages. We can link to other notes right here within AmpleNote. We can start to add some rich text and some tags and some images and all of that good stuff to flesh out our notes. And the thing is I can actually come up here and rename this as well. So maybe I can say these are things to think about this week, for example. So here I've renamed it here. If I go back to Jots, what you'll notice is that now February 1st is empty. Remember this down below was my February 1st Jots? Well, that still exists as a note, but if I want to continue to add information, I can do so here. I think this is really, really smart because as you're adding notes throughout the day, then hopefully you're making some time to put them in a more proper place or grouping them together. But now we still have that opportunity to input more quick notes throughout the day. So getting back to notes, the notes here within AmpleNote have many of the same features that you may be used to when it comes to something like Evernote or perhaps Notion. In fact, the layout is very, very similar to Evernote. We can have different headings. We can add bullet points and again, all the links and everything else that you're used to in most note-taking application. But where I think AmpleNote really shines is the relationship between tasks and adding those tasks within your note-taking tool. So here, for example, I've added a few tasks within this note, and it looks pretty straightforward. I've got a checkbox here. I've got the task written out, and on the right-hand side, I've got a few different options. I can actually choose to hide or snooze these tasks if I don't want them in my face or in my team's face for a while and bring them back at a future time. I can choose a due date, of course, which is going to be standard with your tasks, and I can choose a priority. In this case, this particular task is both urgent and important, but I could just say it's one or the other. But where this really shines is if you pull this drop-down menu and see all of the additional information you can add. So something that not a lot of note-taking apps will include is the ability to repeat a task, for example. I can change the due date. I can set a reminder. Let's say I want a reminder 15 minutes in advance. Here's where I can set that time when, if I do choose to hide this task, here I can change the priority. Maybe this one is only urgent. And when it comes to duration, this one I'm going to say is only about 15 minutes in length. Now, what you may be noticing is this little box here called the task score. And I really think this is brilliant and it's going to help many of you. So often I have people asking me, Scott, what is the perfect formula as to what I should be working on next? Or how do I prioritize a large number of tasks from various different projects or across my life? Well, what AmpleNote is trying to do here is trying to give you a quantitative score so that when you look at all of your tasks across all of your notes, you can decide, or at least help to decide, what should come before something else. So here you can see, if I say the due date is tomorrow, I've got a score of 8. But what if I say it's due today? Oh my goodness, it's a score of 16. Now, I'll be perfectly honest, I'm not exactly sure what the highest number is here. I haven't seen anything above of 20, I believe. I'm not exactly sure how all of these calculations are working, but a lot of them make sense to me. Here under priority, currently it's urgent, but if I say it's important and urgent, it's going to tack on some more information. If I take off that urgent, it actually brings it back drastically or by about 3 task score points or whatever calculation is being used in this case. But I think this is great because when we get to the final section here within AmpleNote, within tasks, now we are bringing in all of our tasks from multiple locations, right? From multiple notes. And here you can see I've got 2 reds based on that task score. I've got a couple of yellows, a blue, and then a few other things here which really don't have a color, primarily because I haven't set a due date or given it that other information. Now, I'm not suggesting that you should attack your task list exactly in this order, but I think by adding this information as a part of your decision making process can help you at the very least. If you don't want to see it in this way, AmpleNote does give you some other ways to group these tasks together. You can group them by their specific notes, even though we're not looking at the note view here. You can also group them by a few other ways as well, if you don't want them necessarily by task score. But one of the things that I really like is that if I don't like the order that I see here, I can adjust it. So let's say I want to bring this task to the very top and work on that first. You can see that it is separated it out. It's created a bit of space. So now I can focus on accomplishing this task before getting to the rest of my particular task list. Now you'll also notice here on the left-hand side, we have a few shortcut keys, and that's going to be dependent on which view you are looking at here. So under tasks, we have things like do this week and high value tasks. Those are the red tasks that we indicated there. If we go back to notes, you can see there's some shortcuts in terms of what we should be doing today, this week, and things that are archived. Another few things that I like about AmpleNote here is that when it comes to images, it is very quick and easy for you to resize those images. How often have you been taking a note and you've pasted in an image and it's taking up way too much space as it pertains to the rest of your notes and the text on your page? AmpleNote also makes it really quick and easy for you to grab all of that text within that image. This isn't necessarily something new, and it's not something that other note-taking apps can't do. I just like that I don't have to click multiple times in order to achieve it. Now I've got all this great text coming directly from this image. Last but not least, let's talk about structure. And you'll notice here on the left-hand side that AmpleNote uses a tag-based system, not a folder-based system. So you can add multiple tags up here at the top. Let's say I want to add marketing tag to this particular note here. But the nice feature is that you can have nested tags or branches of your tag. tags. You'll notice here under website, I have a few things down below, review and task. You can see if I look at this note, it's actually website, or it's written out, tag website/review. So you can nest those tags within other tags, which in many ways just replaces the need for folders in that particular case. So a lot of flexibility here within AmpleNote as well. Now, if you'd like to see what Francesco thinks of AmpleNote, be sure to visit the Simpletivity channel for his full review. Thank you so much for watching today's video, and remember, being productive does not need to be difficult. In fact, it's very simple.